Sim, senti. Sundaralen. Report number of errors. Poisson with a mean of 0.95. So we've got a mean 0.95. So the Poisson is 0.95. It says without use tables, find the probability that a randomly selected page contains one, part one, no errors. So the probability of x equals 0. So I'm using the formula. So for a Poisson of lambda, probability that x equals x e to the minus lambda times lambda to the x over x factorial. So x equals 0 then will be e to the minus 0.95 times 0.95 to the power of 0 divided by 0 factorial. Calculating that. That's 0.3867410235. I'm going to four decimal places. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's 0.3867 because the 4 is less than 5, leaves the 7 alone. Second part, well, they're probably either 3 or 4 errors. 3 or 4, so I'm adding when I see the or. So probably x equals 3 or probably x equals 4. So look, these 12 then add them up. So 3 will be e to the minus 0.95 times 0.95 to the power of 3 over 3 factorial. And for 4, e to the minus 0.95 times 0.95 to the power of 4 over 4 factorial. Right, I can use the replay here, just change the 0 to a 3. Just 0.0552. Then change the 3 to 4. And that's 0.0131242. And then I add those up because it's either 3 or 4. So add the first one onto that. And that's 0.0683888503. 4 decimal places. 1, 2, 3, 4. That 8 is bigger than a 5, so change that 3 to 4. 0.0684. Okay, part B. Alan types a 4-page report. Okay, so the mean for each page, for a single page, is 0.95. So if I got a 4-page report, the mean is going to be 4 lots of 0.95. So this Poisson now will be 4 lots of 0.95. So that's a Poisson of 3.8. In part one, there are no errors anywhere in the report. So that's the probability that x is equal to naught. So from the formula then, that will be e to the minus 3.8 times 3.8 to the power of naught divided by naught factorial. And 0.0223704 8, 6, I'll go to 4 decimal places, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 7, if more than 5 increases to 3 to a 4, so it's 0.0224. Right, the second part, the first error occurs on the third page. Okay, but then the third page, it could contain, we want an error on the third page, it could be one error, two errors, it could be any number of errors, but occurring on the third page. So for that to occur, we want no errors on the first page, and no errors on the second page, and we want an error on the third page. So this is going to be no errors on page one, and no errors on page two, and an error on page three. Okay, so the probability of there being no errors on a page is 0.0224. So the probability that there will be an error on the page, and this could be, I say, any number of errors really, is 1 minus 0.224. So no errors on page 1, that probability is that, and, so it's times, no errors on page 2, so that's 0.0224, and there is an error on page 3, so that'll be 1 minus 0.0224. Multiplying those out, it's 0.0224 times 0.0224 times 1 take away 0.0224, and that gives me an answer of 0.00049052457, and the 4 decimal places 1, 2, 3, 4, it's 0.0005.